Welcome back, students. So this is our period number 3 and topic knowing our numbers, and the sub concepts are unit conversions, use of brackets, and finally we will deal with the word problems. Clear? So first we will discuss about unit conversions. Clear, students? So whenever we go for measurement of a length, we take help of the units. We take help of the units kilometer, meter, centimeter, millimeter, and so on. So these are the units of length or distance measurement. Here, students, you must have seen your milestones where it is written kilometer. If you will go to Bermuda, you will find it is written 1256 kilometer Chennai. Means the distance of Chennai from Bhubaneswar, it is mentioned there. So this is one milestone to measure the or to know the distance. Clear? Similarly, whenever you are going to purchase cloth to make your uniform, you are going to the shop and you are asking, you give 2 meters of cloth. So you are taking help of the unit meter. And centimeter, you must have your centimeter scale and a millimeter scale also. Whenever you are constructing the length, the line segments, clear, you are taking the help of the centimeter and a millimeter scale to draw or to measure your line segments. So if length is one physical quantity, kilometer, meter, centimeter, millimeter, these are the units. So, but we must know how to convert one unit to another one unit, which is called as your unit conversions. Clear? So if you want to convert kilometer to meter, you have to multiply 1000, because 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. If you want to convert meter to centimeter, you have to multiply 100. Why? Because 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. And if you want to multiply or convert centimeter to millimeter, you have to multiply 10, because 1 centimeter equal to 10 millimeter. Clear, students? Similarly, these are the conversion of greater units to smaller units. Similarly, if you want to convert kilometer to centimeter, this is also greater to smaller. Here 100 and here 1000. So we'll multiply 1 with 5 zeros. Is it clear? If you want to convert kilometer to centimeter, you have to convert. Here is 1 with 3 zeros, 1 with 2 zeros, so 1 with 5 zeros. And if you want to multiply kilometer to this one, so you have to multiply 1 with 6 zeros. Clear? So these are all about unit conversions, how to convert greater units to smaller units. Clear? Similarly, if you want to convert meter to millimeter, 100 into 10, you have to multiply 1000. Clear? You have to multiply 1000. So these are all about conversion of bigger units to smaller units. Once more, kilometer to meter into 1000, meter to centimeter into 100, centimeter to millimeter into 10, kilometer to centimeter into 1 with 5 zeros, 1 lakh. Similarly, kilometer to millimeter, this line, into 10 lakh. Clear? Similarly, meter to millimeter into 1000. Clear? So these are all about conversion of bigger units to smaller units. We will come to the reverse, that is, how to convert smaller units to bigger units, smaller to bigger. If you want to convert meter to kilometer, what to do? you have to divide 1000, because kilometer to meter into 1000, so meter to kilometer divided by 1000. Similarly, meter to centimeter into 100, similarly centimeter to meter divided by 100. Clear? Similarly, centimeter to millimeter into 10, so millimeter to centimeter in divided by 10. So similarly, if you want to convert millimeter to meter, what to do? Divide by 1000. Clear? If you want to convert millimeter to kilometer, divided by 1 with 6 zeros. Clear? So these are about meter to kilometer. Again, centimeter to kilometer. Centimeter to kilometer. That is, this one divided by 1 with 5 zeros. Clear? So millimeter to centimeter, millimeter to meter, millimeter to kilometer. Similarly, centimeter to meter, centimeter to kilometer, and a meter to kilometer. So these are the, if you want to convert smaller units to bigger units, if you want to convert smaller to bigger, then you have to go for division. Smaller units to bigger unit division, bigger units to smaller unit multiplication. Clear? So this is all about unit conversions. Now we will discuss how to convert 11 kg 25 gram to grams. Clear? Students, 11 kg 25 gram. 11 kg 25 gram equal to, you have to convert into grams. So 11 kg you convert into gram first. 11 into, you want to convert sorry students, before that I will tell you about the gram also. Similarly, just 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. So before this solving this problem, you must have idea about gram and kilogram. 1 kilogram equal to 1000 gram. Clear? And similarly, if you want to convert kilogram to gram, you have to multiply 1000. Clear? Kilogram to gram, multiply 1000. Similarly, if you want to convert gram to centigram, gram to centigram. Previously, suppose meter to centimeter. What you have done? Meter to centimeter into 100. Similarly, gram to centigram into 100. Clear? Into 100. Because meter to centimeter, 1 meter, 100 centimeter. So 1 gram also 100 centigram. Clear? Similarly, centigram to milligram. Centigram to milligram. First you see centimeter to millimeter. Centimeter to millimeter, what you have done? Into 10. So similarly here also into 10. So before solving this problem, you must have idea about kilogram, 1 kilogram, 1000 gram. 1 gram equal to 100 centigram. And 1 centigram equal to 10 milligram. Clear? So now we will solve the problem. Clear? Because your meter centimeter you have idea, and this is about gram and centigram. So 11 kg 25 gram to grams. 11 kg 25 gram equal to, first you convert kilogram into gram, that is 11 into 1000 gram plus 25 gram. Clear? 11 kg 25 gram equal to 11 into 1000 gram, because 1 kg is here 1000 gram. Clear? So equal to 11000 gram. 11,000 gram plus 25 gram equal to 11025 gram. So this is the way how to convert 11 kg 25 gram to grams. Is it clear? Next you see 7 meter 25 centimeter into meter. Clear? So first one is correct. Second one will convert 7 meter 27 centimeter to meter. Clear? 7 meter 27 centimeter. Students, 1 meter, already you have written earlier, 1 meter equal to 100 centimeter. So this is 7 into 100 centimeter plus 27 centimeter equal to 700 centimeter plus 27 centimeter equal to 727 centimeter. But our objective to convert into meter. If you want to convert into meter, I told you centimeter to meter divide by 100. So equal to 727 divided by 100. Whenever 100 you have divided, immediately the unit will be meter. So this is 7.27 meter. That means 7 meter 27 centimeter equal to 7.27 meter. Clear? Okay. Now we will discuss about use of brackets. Unit conversions over use of brackets. Students, whenever you will use the brackets, and I think you must have an idea about Bodmas rule. If no, then we will discuss. But whenever you will go for any calculation, we will give priority to the brackets first. Clear? We will give priority to the brackets first. So that now we will discuss about use of brackets. Let us consider one problem, that is 27 minus 4 into 3 plus 2. So I told you, we will give priority to the brackets, means operations inside the bracket you have to do first. Clear? So if you want to do bracket first, this is 27 minus 4 into 3 plus 2. 3 plus 2 is 5. Clear? Now you apply your D, B, O, D, M, A, S. I think you have knowledge about your Bodmas rule. B means bracket, O means off, D means division, M means multiplication, A means addition, and finally S means subtraction. So if we apply the same one, the B, first the B, the bracket, already the bracket work already you have completed and you have written 5. So now what to do? Your O off, off is not there. Next to D, D division is not there. These two are the unknown things here. Next is your multiplication. So now 27 minus 4 into 5. 4 into 5 is 20. So your multiplication over. Now you have to see the addition, but there is no addition fact. So addition is not there. So finally we will go for subtraction. So 27 minus 20 equal to 7, which is your answer. Clear? So this is all about your bracket. And some problems are given in your book that to solve the problems using this bracket or solve some expansions. Clear? So now finally we will discuss some word problems which are given in your book. And if you will see your book, that is your 1.3, you will find one problem. To stitch a shirt, 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Clear? Just means if you in order to prepare or make one shirt, you need 215 centimeter cloth. That is 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth. Out of 38 meter 70 centimeter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched? That means first you must know that how much length of cloth is required to make one shirt or to stitch one shirt, and how much cloth available, 38 meter 70 centimeter. Clear? And here the question given, how many shirts can be stitched and will there be any cloth left? Please, if you will refer your book, it will be better. This question particularly given, and the answer I will write here. First you write how much cloth required to stitch one shirt. Clear? So you write cloth required for one shirt. How much? 2 meter 15 centimeter. Clear? 2 meter 15 centimeter, and you convert into centimeter, equal to 215 centimeter. Clear? Cloth required for one shirt, 215 centimeter, and a total cloth or length of cloth available, total length of cloth available equal to 38 meter 70 centimeter. Now also 38 meter 70 centimeter, you have to convert into centimeter, just like you have converted here. And I told you earlier how to convert 7 meter 27 centimeter to meter. Clear? And here we have converted into centimeter, so which is equal to 3870 centimeter. Clear? Simply you multiply 100 with this, 2 into 100 200 plus 15. Here 38 into 100 38 100 plus 70, so 3870, that 3870 centimeter cloth. So one shirt requires this much cloth and total length of cloth available this much, so number of shirts can be made. So number of shirts can be made or stitched equal to 3870 centimeter. Do not forget to write the centimeter or unit, divide by 215 centimeter. If you divide, the answer will be 18, and the remainder will be 0. Clear? If you divide 3870 by 215, the answer you will get as 18, and no cloth will remain. So finally the answer, question asked, will there be any cloth left, you write no. Answer is no. That means the remainder is 0. Clear? Once again you listen the question. To stitch a shirt, 2 meter 15 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 38 meter 70 centimeter cloth, how many shirts can be stitched? Will there be any cloth left? So our answer is, your cloth required for one shirt, this much centimeter. Total length of cloth available, this much centimeter. So number of shirts can be stitched or made, 3870 centimeter divided by 215 centimeter. Centimeter, centimeter cancelled, and 3870 divided by 215 equal to 18. So 18 number of shirts can be made, and remainder will be 0. That's why the last part of your question, will there be any cloth left? Answer is no. Why no? Because the remainder is here, you are getting 0 in the division. Clear? Now let us consider another one word problem from the same exercise 1.3. Clear? The question also, it is given in your book. You will refer your book, it is better. In the Lok Sabha election, in a constituency, The successful candidate polled 18,25,355 votes and won the election by a margin of 1,37,415 votes. How many votes did his nearest rival polled? That means total number of votes in favor of the successful or the person who won the election given. Marginal vote given. You have to find a number of votes in favor of the nearest rival. Clear? So how to do this one? First you write votes in favor of the successful candidate. Clear? Votes in favor of the successful candidate. Votes in favor of the successful candidate. How much? 18,25,355. The candidate who won the election, this much votes got. And the marginal vote means won by 1,37,415 means the marginal votes. Marginal votes equal to 1,37,415. So, number of votes in favor of the nearest rival. So, number of votes in favor of the nearest rival equal to, what to do? This is the total vote got and this is the marginal vote. So this minus this. Clear? 18,25,355 minus the marginal vote 1,37,415. And the subtraction value will be 16,87,940. Once again you verify. 5 minus 5, 0. 5 minus 1, 4. 3, 13 minus 4, 9. And here is a 4. 4 means 14. 14 minus 7, 7. And here is 1. That is 11. 11 minus 3 is 8. Then here is 17. 17 minus 1, 16. Clear? So once again you listen the question which is given in your book. In the Lok Sabha election in a constituency, the successful candidate polls 18,25,355 votes and won the election by a margin of 1,37,415 votes. How many votes did his nearest rival polled? So votes in favor of the successful candidate this much. The marginal votes 1,37,415. So number of votes in favor of the nearest rival 18,25,355 minus 1,37,415 equal to 16,87,940. I think you understood. Okay. So now we'll discuss one more problem. So students, if I will write the question, I think it will create a problem. That's why I am not writing the question. It will be unnecessary wastage of time. So if you will see your book, I think the question will get. Next one is your, the number of sheets of paper available for making notebooks is 101,25,000. Means total number of paper sheets available 1,25,000. Each sheet makes 8 pages of notebooks. That means if you will take one page, let us consider this is one page. Clear? One sheet of paper. This is one sheet of paper. If I will fold it, clear? How many pages you are getting? Page number 1, page number 2, page number 3, page number 4. But again, if you will fold this one sheet of paper, you will get how many pages? 8 pages. Page number 1, page number 2, page number 3, page. Students, this is one sheet of paper. Clear? This is one sheet of paper. And here, in this one sheet of paper, here you are getting one page, and here is also one page. So how many pages you are getting? 2 pages. Now let me to fold it once. If I will fold it once, you are getting 4 pages. You see, this is your page number 1, page number 2, page number 3, and page number 4. If once more I will fold it, how many pages you are getting? You are getting 8 pages. How? Page number 1, this is your page number 2, page number 3, this is your page number 4, page number 5, page number 6, page number 7, and page number 8. So one sheet of paper you will convert into 8 pages. Clear? So let me to write the solution. So the solution we will start writing now. So first, number of pages from one sheet, 8. That means if you are using one sheet, you are getting 8 pages. But how many sheets available? 1,25,000. So number of pages from 1,25,000 sheets equal to 1,25,000 into 8. This much number of pages. No need to multiply. If you multiply, it will be complicated for you, for your division. Now we will see how many pages are there in one notebook. In one notebook, 250 pages are there. You write number of pages in one notebook equal to 250. Number of pages in one notebook, 250. So number of notebooks can be made this product divided by 250. 125,000 into 8 by 250. Clear? Or this product divided by 250. Whenever you will divide, divide both the numbers by 10. Again, you divide 125,000, that is 12,500, by 25. 25 cancelled by 125, cancelled by 25 is 5 and 2 zeros. That is 500. 500 into 8 equal to 4000. So number of notebooks can be made equal to 4000. Is it clear now? So students, once more you listen. The question is given in your book. Number of sheets of paper available for making notebooks is 1,25,000. Each sheet makes 8 pages of notebooks. Each notebook contains 250 pages. How many notebooks can be made from the sheets available? Clear? So first, number of pages available from one sheet, 8. But how many sheets are available? 1,25,000. So how many pages will be available? 1,25,000 into 8. But how many pages are there in one notebook? 250. So number of notebooks can be made this product divided by this. That is 125,000 × 8/250. This is one easy way of calculation. Otherwise, if you multiply this with this, you will get 1 with 6 zeros, means 10 lakh. Again, 10 lakh you will divide by 250, same 4000 you will get. Clear? So, this is your problem from your book. Let us discuss one more problem and we will end the period number 3 here. Clear? Now, next question. A bookshop sold 8,538 books in the month of June. 8,538 books in the month of June. Its sale rose by 212 books in the next month. Next month, its selling increased by 212 books. If profit on selling one book is 25,000, find the total profit in these 2 months. Clear? So first you find how many books sold in the month of June, then how many books in the month of July, then add both how many total selling, then you multiply 25 to get the profit. Clear? So right answer. Number of books sold in the month of June, that is 8538. Clear? 8538. Number of books sold in the month of June. Again, number of books sold in the month of July. How much? Increased by 212. That is 8538 + 212. Now 38 + 12 is 50, and 85 + 2 = 87. So 8750. Clear? So this is the selling in the month of June. This is the selling in the month of July. So total selling. How many? 8538 + 8750. 50 + 38, this is 88. Then 85 and is 87. 7 + 5 = 2 = 17 = 88. So this is the number of books sold in the month of both June and July. Now, what is the profit from one book? 25 rupees. Then what is the profit from 17,288 books? You will multiply 25. You write profit from one book. How much? Rupees 25. So, profit from 17,288 books, rupees 25 into 17,288 equal to, the product will be 432,200. Clear? 432,200. That means if you multiply 25 with 17,288, you will get 432,200. Clear? And this is the end of your period number 3. And students, you will do homework as your exercise
or that is LUP, that is 1.3. Clear?
Thank you. I hope you will do the problems.
Okay.